ready to match the stars. Bob Barker, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Arlene Francis, Richard Dawson, and Fanny Flagg as we play the star-studded big money match game, PM. And now here's the star of match game PM, Gene Ryder.
Shall we sell out, Johnny? Shall we sell all our shares in the... No. How are you? You got a good bunch here, and you got a good bunch out there, and you got a good bunch here. Here. How's the bunch tonight?
Oh, I haven't looked lately.
That'd be none of that.
Oh, okay.
Anything I can do for anybody here?
No. You have any raid?
Any raid?
Sweet lady, would you?
What would you like to say hello to our two players over
yes,
here? Verna Jones and Greg Fox. Now, we'd like to find out a little something about each of you. Greg, we'll begin with you. Please tell us the story of your life in 8 seconds. Ready? Go.
Well, I'll be married 8 years, 5 years this December.
All right, Greg, now
just
make up your mind.
Like seems eight. Like eight.
Are you really married, Greg?
Yes, I'm really married.
You really are married?
Positive.
And how many years you've been married?
Five this December.
Okay, right. Continue.
We have a beautiful adopted daughter, Nicole Elizabeth, 9 months old.
That's a marvelous idea.
I'm a junior high school physical education teacher, and I also coach football at a high school, and that's why my voice is gone this week.
Well, you've been hollering a lot.
A little bit.
Yes. Don't you have a one of those bullhorns so you can talk to the players on the field without hollering that much?
It's built in.
It is?
Yes.
All right. All right. Greg, we wish you the best of luck. Nice to have you here. Now, Verna Jones.
Okay.
Where are you from?
From British Honduras.
From what?
British Honduras.
From the British Honduras?
Yes.
That's the first time we've had one of those, isn't it?
That's true. Not a moment too soon.
That's right. All right, Verna, what else?
Okay, I work as a dental assistant in a children's dental office, and like I said, I'm from British Honduras. My husband is also from British Honduras. And we've got a cute little six-year-old boy named Sean and an old English sheepdog named Cotton.
Okay. And you have lovely teeth.
Thank you. I brush a lot.
And you get rid of the... You get rid of the plaque on your teeth.
I sure do, yes.
She has her plaque under control in her mouth. That's a terrible thing that causes caries, right?
Yes.
Or cavities,
what is this,
as we say.
Is this a Pepsodent commercial?
Yes. No, it isn't. All right, are you both ready to play there? I want to remind you that you're going to try to match as many of our celebrities as you can, and the winner goes on to play the Big Money Super Match, which can pay off over $10,000. All right.
Yahoo!
Greg, we'll ask you to make the selection here. Do you want A or B?
B, please.
B it is. Here we go, folks. Kojak said... He said...
Hey, Zoe, you won't believe this, baby, but when I put on my wig... I look like blank.
Kojak said that.
Kojak said.
When I put on my wig, I look like blank.
Oh, there are so many choices.
Yes.
Well, the first round questions are like that. There are a number of good choices. We narrow it down a little bit later. Okay. Are you finished? Bob,
I have finished.
You have finished. Okay, all the lights are on up there, and we're waiting for Fanny. Just put it in the slot there, and away we go. We come to Greg Fox. Kojak said, you won't believe this, baby, but when I put on my wig, I look like blank.
Rock Hudson.
Rock Hudson, he says. Oh. Wait a minute. He's a teacher and a coach and a father who's been married 5 or 8 years, depending on...
And a terrific yellow.
You're ashamed of...
Brett.
Yeah. Brett.
I was
thinking of movie stars, weren't you?
That really surprised me. That never crossed my mind.
Well, it's the only thing that crossed my mind.
Really?
I wear my own hair now.
That's right. She doesn't wear the wigs anymore.
They worked on it for 2 hours before the show. I watched.
So? I was going to say Gina Lola Brigida, but I realized that she was Italian, and he's Greek, right?
Yes.
So I said Paul Newman.
Paul Newman, a beautiful human being. Yes.
Cute as a... Don't knock Paul Newman, honey.
Paul Newman ain't bad. Kojak was just funding a leaves kidding around there a little bit. Charles.
I love Charles.
Well, there was so many answers. I just said I look like hell.
Kojak said, you won't believe this, baby, but when I put on my wig, I look like Rock Hudson, according to Greg Fox. What, according to Arlene Francis?
I mean no offense to Rock Hudson, but I said a woman.
All right. Moving right along, Richard.
As fast as possible.
Yes. When Telly pops that old wig on,
yeah,
he looks like Cher.
Cher! Oh, there it is. That's it. Yeah. No Rock Hudson so far, Greg. Let's see if we get a Rock Hudson out of Fanny. I'll start all over. Yeah. Let's see if we get a Fanny out of Rock Hudson.
No, we said Rock Hudson, Paul Newman, in the same family, Richard Dawson.
Oh, all the beautiful people mentioned in one breath there. Now, Verna Jones, your first round question reads as follows. Listen carefully. Mrs. Perkins said...
Out at the home, we don't have a TV set. So for entertainment, we all get together in the parlor and we watch Old Man Periwinkle try to blank. That's what we do.
Do it again.
I like Mrs. Perkins. Form a big circle, see? Form this big circle. We stand around there, watch Old Man Periwinkle try to blank.
We're at the home, right?
At the home, yes.
Okay, I got it.
Don't have a TV set there, you see? It's the way it is.
I got it, dear.
You're not a bad
These
looking...
These windows are closed.
You're not a bad looking young man, you know that?
Thank you.
He's not young.
He's not young? He looks young to me, honey.
I like Mrs. Perkins.
Did you do that, I hope?
Do what, your hamburger?
Everybody ready to the lower tier? Everybody ready to the upper tier? We come to Verna Jones. Mrs. Perkins says...
She's cute, isn't she?
Thank you.
Out of the home, we don't have a TCFT.
Get the Aurifex.
Out of the home, we don't have a TV set. So for entertainment, what we do is, you see, we form this big circle. Everybody stands around and we watch Old Man Periwinkle try to blank.
To strip.
To strip.
What did she say?
She says, watch Old Man Periwinkle try to strip. That means take it off.
Yes. I don't know whether he was trying to take it off or whether he already had it off, but Mr. Periwinkle now is a... he's in the home, is he not?
He's one of us,
he's
yes.
One of,
well, not exactly
well,
one of us.
They watched Mr. Periwinkle try to get up.
Just stand up. Well... It's difficult. You know how it is once you're sitting down in those comfortable chairs.
No, I'm a young person.
Oh.
I can snap right up there. I said he tried to make one of the inmates. He was just patting her and all that stuff.
Okay.
I went along with Robert. I said stand up.
Stand up. So we don't have Verna Jones' answer yet, which is strip. For entertainment, we all get together in the parlor, watch Old Man Periwinkle try to strip. What do you say?
I say that while he was doing it, he danced a little.
Yes, that's the upside down dance. There is
the
right side up dance on his head.
He was very old.
Danced on his head. Try it. We're looking for a stripper, Richard.
Waltzing Matilda, an Australian dance.
Waltzing Matilda, no.
No, they all stood around and watched the old hamburger periwinkle.
Yes?
Tried to walk.
Oh! Oh,
brother.
Difficult. Mm. What do you say there?
I say under the B, three.
Got it.
No, I say they all tried to watch him breathe.
That's where it goes. So, as any fool can plainly see, zip to zip, here it is. We're going to go out of business unless you get hot here. When you're hot, you're hot. Well, you're going to get hot right after these messages. Come back. We're ready to carry on. All right, we finished round one. Neither of our contestants has matched any of our celebrities, so we'll push this button, go to round two, and I want to point out to you, in the interim, while you were gone, his microphone got sick, and we called the ambulance and took it away, and they're repairing it now. And in case it doesn't get back, I will just... See, that's why I have this long telescopic microphone here, so I can say, Greg, make your selection.
Right.
Right. Right. No, it's A or B, Greg.
A or B.
A or B, noise. No, I got so engrossed in telling you about his sick microphone, I forgot that he went first last time. And since the score is tied, zip to zip here, pitcher's duel, she goes first this time. And you have a working microphone there, so we ask you A or B.
I'll go with B.
B. Thank you for straightening me out, Greg. You're fired. The mummy said. The mummy said, the guy who wrapped me did a lousy job. He left my blank sticking out. Vern is thinking about that. Good. Okay, these two are finished. Charles is ready.
Good. I'm almost ready. Is Fanny ready?
No hands.
All right.
Would you like to see it?
No, no, no. I trust you implicitly.
Oh, I'm so glad.
Yes.
All right. I'm ready.
Okay. Verna.
Things are going beautifully so far.
The mummy said... The guy who wrapped me did a lousy job. He left my blank sticking out.
He left my fanny sticking out.
You said that?
Yes.
Okay.
What did she say?
She said he left my fanny sticking out. That's what she said.
I didn't even know him.
Fanny sticking out for years. What did you say, Bob?
I said, back to the rest home. I was working a little higher area. I said, no.
Nose is very good. That's a good response. First is not bad. Nose is okay.
Thank the multitude who applauded that.
Yeah. Eight people agreed with you. That ain't bad.
No.
What do
you
say?
They were on the right, those eight people.
Yes.
Way over there. Now, in the middle, we're going to have a large burst of applause because I said nether region.
Nether region, which is a match. That's one for Verna. The nether region.
The nether region of a person's body is away from their nose.
Right, Charles.
Thank you so much, Dr. Sinclair.
Tongue for a boring answer.
Tongue for a boring answer. All right. So we've had one match so far. Verna Jones is looking for the guy who brought me did a lousy job. He left my fanny sticking out, according to her. What according to you, Arlene?
Well, I have ESP for British Honduras, and I said fanny.
Oh, there it is. Two for Verna. Ricardo.
I was always... told to keep my nose out of other people's business.
Oh, I see. That's right.
Brilliant answer.
Okay, nose is brilliant, isn't it? Yes, of course. Now, Fanny. She's looking for Fanny.
I know she is. God bless her. I said nose on her. I was a whack.
So that's two for you. And now, Greg, we've come to your second round question. You must match two to tie, three to win. The health inspector said, he said, now this is the health inspector, he said, boy, is that restaurant filthy. It's so filthy, not even the blanks will eat there.
That restaurant filthy.
It's so,
so filthy,
filthy,
not
even
the
blanks
will
eat there.
Oh, right. There are two terrific choices. I can't make up my mind.
All right. That's good.
That's very
That's
good.
That's
good. Very good.
Okay. Right. Just checking up on everybody here. Okay. Now we come over here to Greg. The health inspector said, boy, is that restaurant filthy. It's so filthy, not even the blanks will eat there. Oh, you need the mic. Oh, Thank you, Greg. I don't know how I'd do the show without you.
Cockroaches.
They don't say cockroaches, they're gonna get lynched, aren't they? Okay, Bob.
Okay, well,
say cockroaches.
As a man who just had his home fumigated, I was tempted to say termites, but I knew they'd boo. Instead, I said ants.
You said ants.
Ants. Boo. One more outburst and the marshals will clear the courtroom.
Now, Brett.
What did I say?
What did you say?
I said there were two terrific choices, correct?
Yes. Cockroaches was one.
I narrowed it down, and I said roaches as
roaches!
That's one for Greg.
Charles?
I wish I'd have said cockroaches, because I didn't know if you came from New York. Eastern play. Western, we don't have cockroaches.
Oh, yes, we do.
Not really.
Really?
I've seen them in your kitchen.
Now, you're not from here, are you? Isn't that true? They're not so, whatever that word is.
Are they prevalent here?
Prevalent.
No.
All right, so I thought he might know that. So all I can say is rats.
Rats. Okay. The health inspector said, boy, is that restaurant filthy? It's so filthy, not even the blanks will eat here. And cockroaches is the answer he's looking for.
I come from the East.
Roaches.
High score.
Now, Richard. Do you break the tie?
I'll tell you how filthy it was.
How filthy was it?
Not even the owners would eat.
Not even the owners would eat. Fanny, do you untie the score?
I've never seen one. Except you... Brett and I went out to dinner once and she opened her little purse and one ran right up on the table. It's a cockroach.
Cockroach. Congratulations. You stand by for a moment. Verna. It was a pleasure meeting you.
Same here.
You're a dear, sweet lady. We've got some gifts for you together with our thanks for being on Match Game PM. Verna Jones, while we're spinning her app, we'll spin these messages for you. Well, time now for the Big Money Super Match, Greg, where you can win over $10,000. Now, to do that, we've got two audience matches for you, and whatever you win in these audience matches, you'll have a chance to multiply by 10. Now, let's get right to it here. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Wedding blank. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it. If you match the middle one, you get $250, and the bottom one gets you $100. Three of our celebrities are permitted to assist. Whom do you call on?
Richard.
Wedding cake.
Wedding cake. There's one.
Fanny.
I have it.
What?
Wedding dress.
Dress. There's a wedding dress. Got a wedding cake and a wedding dress.
So?
And Brent.
Oh, there are so many choices. I can't decide which
say
one.
Say one.
Shotgun.
No. Wedding.
What about wedding bells?
Wedding bells. So you got bells, cake, and dress.
I'll go with Brent and bells.
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh, I hope you're right.
All right. Sorry. All right, he's going to go with Brent's answer and say wedding bells.
Oh.
Let's begin down at the bottom here and see if wedding bells is under the $100 response. Wedding night. Nobody thought of that. It's been so long. Looking for
with
wedding
me, it
bells.
Never was.
Here's the $250 response. Wedding ring.
Oh, my Lord.
So far, we're striking out here.
Oh,
last chance for wedding
it.
Bells. Slide it, Earl. Wedding bells. Congratulations, Greg. You've won the $500, which means that the least you'll be playing for is 10 times that amount, or $5,000. Now let's see how much more you can win with our second audience match. Are you ready, Earl?
I'm ready.
He's ready. All right, we polled another audience, and we got their best response to this. Blank the Lion. All right, whom do you call on here?
Richard.
Leo.
Leo the Lion.
Arlene.
Arlene, have you got one?
The Lamb.
Land, the lamb and the lion.
They lay down together. You remember your
yes,
Bible,
right,
of course.
Okay.
Right.
And Brett again.
How about Androcles and the lion?
Androcles and the lion. Okay, so you got Androcles and the lion, the lamb and the lion, and Leo the lion.
Leo the lion.
Leo the lion's the one you want. Let's see if Leo the lion is hiding under the $100 response. Clarence the Lion. Clarence, now you remember her. All right, let's see if Leo the Lion is under the $250 response. The Wind and the Lion. Very intellectual group we had here that day. Last chance for Leo the Lion. Here's the $500 response. $500, we multiply that by 10, makes 5,000, add that to the other 5,000. He's shooting for a pot of $10,000. Now, to collect that, you got to match one celebrity head to head exactly. Which one will it be?
Richard.
All right, Richard, you get ready to write, and Greg, you face me. Here is the $10,000 question. Up and blank. Up and blank.
Too easy.
Up and blank. Okay, he's finished. Now, Greg Fox, we need an answer from you which you think will match his. What do you say to that? Up and
down.
Up and down. Up and down. All right. He says up and down will match you, Richard.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I thought of the song Up, Up and Down.
Everybody I know.
Your wife?
My wife, friends.
They're all there. All right, they're screaming and hollering for Greg Fox. You've got $11,000. Congratulations to you. We'll be back with Greg in a moment or so. You were all splendid. Gene Mabern here. See you guys next time for Match Game PM. Goodbye. Yeah.